Aloha, I'm Pauline Chin, and I'm excited to share with you this first module, the history of infectious diseases in Hawaii and the Pacific. I grew up in Kaimuki on Oahu. My mom and dad were both teachers. My family on both sides came to Hawaii during the kingdom. They knew it would be a good place to find work. But why was that? Unfortunately, it was because so many Hawaiians had died from infectious diseases that people were needed to work on plantations, farms, and ranches. You've all visited Waikiki. Imagine visiting in the 1850s. Instead of hotels, you see a traditional structure, a smallpox hospital that isolated patients to stop the spread of a highly infectious virus that killed a third of adults and half of children who got infected. Why study the Pacific's history of introduced infectious diseases? What can we learn from the experiences, values, and actions of Hawaiians and Pacific Island peoples to guide us in the current COVID-19 pandemic? This map of the Pacific tells the story of oceanic peoples who lived on a multitude of islands far from infectious diseases that developed in Europe and Asia. Because people had no exposure to disease organisms, they also had no immunity. Contact with Europeans led to epidemics of measles, flu, and smallpox that killed 40% or more of the people. So many people became sick or died that families and villages no longer could function. In the pandemic of 1918, 20% of Western Samoans died of Spanish flu when ships returning from World War I passed through the islands. But no one died in American Samoa, only 40 miles away, due to a strict quarantine. Before Western contact, oceanic peoples generally enjoyed good health. People had herbal medicines that worked well with familiar diseases, but not with those brought by foreigners. Hawaii had medical specialists, kahuna haha, who memorized the characteristics and history of diseases from the place and time of first appearance to the present. These diagnosticians were like today's COVID-19 contact tracers. But when foreign diseases appeared, Hawaiians observed repeated epidemics with many deaths. They came up with a new saying that expressed this pattern. Lawe li'i li'i ka make aka Hawaii. Lawe nui ka make aka haole. Death by Hawaiians takes a few at a time. Death by foreigners takes many. Here's Hawaii's historical relationship with introduced diseases. The timeline begins around 1400, when oral histories say voyaging between Hawaii and Tahiti ceased after the death of Moikeha, a high chief from Tahiti who lived in Hawaii. Hawaii was isolated for 400 years until Western contact in 1788, when British sailors introduced sexually transmitted diseases and tuberculosis. The timeline records outbreaks of cholera, whooping cough, leprosy, measles, and flu that killed thousands of vulnerable Hawaiians. In 1850, Kamehameha III appointed a board of health leading to the building of the smallpox hospital shown in the opening slide. By the last decades of the 19th century, an estimated 90% of Hawaiians had perished of foreign diseases. It is during these troubled times that my ancestors and the ancestors of many Kama'aina families arrived in Hawaii to find work. Mina mina ia ka ike Hawaii. Hawaiian knowledge is valued. Mina mina can mean to regret, be sorry, deplore, to grieve for something. It can also mean to value greatly, especially something in danger of being lost. The painting showing a mother and her child expresses the saying, He mea mina mina ia kekeki. A child is to be prized. About a third of babies died before reaching a year. We saw in the timeline that King Kamehameha III established a Department of Health in 1850. He also knew the loss of people, especially the elders who were living libraries, meant loss of knowledge. In 1840, he established Hawaii's public education system, the oldest system west of the Mississippi, and the only system established by a reigning monarch. The ali'i wanted everyone to become educated. More than 1,000 schools were established, at least one in every ahupua'a, land division, enabling literacy to spread across all islands. The ali'i encouraged people to share their knowledge in newspapers that helped news and knowledge spread widely. King Kalakaua himself was an editor of one of the 100-plus Hawaiian language newspapers published between 1834 and 1948. Many articles report the suffering and attempts to understand and treat the new diseases. The kingdom prioritized public health by kilo, which means monitoring or observing carefully for disease. Beginning in 1836, the harbor pilot checked foreign ships for evidence of disease, and a quarantine law and vital statistics act were passed in 1839. The population was estimated to be around 400,000 when Captain Cook made contact in 1788. By the time of the first census, the population had declined to a fourth of the original population, to 82,035. Population declined until Hawaiians were a minority in their own islands. The illegal overthrow of Queen Liliuokalani in 1893 shows how a century of foreign diseases and death weakened the kingdom, leaving it vulnerable to political threats. Actions of ali'i show their visionary leadership. Before the epidemics of foreign diseases, there was no need for hospitals or institutions to care for elders and orphans. But when the need arose, Hawaii's kings and queens used their own time, money, and lands to found Queen's Hospital in 1859, Lunalilo Home for the Elderly in 1874, Kapiolani Women's Hospital in 1890, and Liliuokalani Trust for Poor and Orphan Children in 1909. Princess Bernice Pauahi Bishop's 1888 will dedicated her royal lands to education. Ho'omalo ikawa mamua, a ho'omalo no ikawa ma hope. This slide highlights the early actions and policies taken by the Hawaiian Kingdom to protect public health. The 1836 notice to the pilot of Honolulu orders him to ascertain if ships arriving from the northwest coast of America have had any case of smallpox or other pestilent disease on board for the last 42 days. This is where we get the word quarantine, which in Italian means 40 days. Whaling ships and ships in the northwest China fur and sandalwood trade stopped in Hawaii for provisions. Hawaiian sailors introduced salt salmon to the Hawaiian diet. We know it today as lomi lomi salmon. Let's focus now on the Princess Liliuokalani's leadership during a smallpox epidemic in 1881. King Kalakaua was traveling, and as Queen Kapiolani did not seek the role of regent, his sister, Princess Liliuokalani, served as Princess Regent. She had to make the same hard choice that leaders face today in the COVID-19 pandemic. Should she lock down Oahu to protect people on neighbor islands or let business go on as usual? She explains her decision in her autobiography. Quote, "Our past experience with the disease had shown us how fatal it might become to the Hawaiian people, and whatever the inconveniences, it became necessary at all hazards to prevent its spread. Summoning the cabinet, I had all arrangements perfected to stay the progress of the epidemic. Communication between the different islands of the group was stopped. Vessels were absolutely prohibited from taking passengers. A strict quarantine of all persons infected or under suspicion was maintained. And so scrupulously and energetically were these regulations enforced that when they were relaxed and quarantine raised, it was found that no case had been reported outside the place of its first appearance. But it was a serious thing to confine its ravages to the city of Honolulu, in which there were some 800 cases and about 300 deaths. Close quote. Though there were 300 deaths on Oahu, there would likely be many more if infected people had carried it to other islands. Connecting past, present, and future. Nahonua Maoli Ola is a Hawaiian philosophy that health, Maoli Ola, is connected to three piko each person has: I, spiritual, the head; O, family, belly button; and A, next generation, genitals. The diagram shows that in Hawaiian culture, no one is an isolated individual as viewed in American culture. Our three piko connect us to the past through our learning, to the present through our family, and to future generations. Maoli, self, is not individually created, but develops within family, community, nation, and world, across our entire lifetime from childhood to adulthood to our elder status. If we look at the actions of Hawaiian leaders, we see they made decisions to care for others, especially the most vulnerable, from keiki to kupuna. Following their examples, if we care for others during the COVID-19 pandemic, we care for ourselves too. We are all connected. It is our shared kuleana, or responsibility, as part of our relationships with others. What happened when six Tongan boys were shipwrecked for 15 months on a Kapu island? This video shows the values of caring for others and learning from parents and elders are shared by Pacific peoples. Instead, they were shipwrecked on a Kapu island, forbidden, after a ship kidnapped villagers for forced labor a century ago. The video shows how they survived and formed a healthy community, growing food, finding water, building shelters, and resolving issues. After 15 months, they were found by chance by an Australian fisherman and returned to Tonga, where they had been given up for dead. Think about the values, practices, decisions, and knowledge that enabled the teenagers to survive and create their community. What were the sources of the strengths that enabled their survival? How did the boys share leadership and defuse conflict and anger? How does their survival show that when we care for others, we also care for ourselves? This story about working together to overcome problems has a message for us during COVID-19. We can help our families, communities, and Hawaii return to our normal lives by learning about COVID-19, wearing a mask, and getting vaccinated to protect ourselves and those around us. The following slides contain a glossary, definitions of words used in this lesson, a quiz on material. If you're at a computer, you can take and retake the quiz to check your learning. We also have material for educators so they know the content standards addressed in this module, and then you can check further resources about COVID-19. I hope you've enjoyed this module. If there's anything we've learned from the past, it's that Pacific peoples are stronger when we work together. It's no different with COVID-19. If you want to get tested, you can. If you want to get vaccinated, you can. Let's all work together. We are stronger together. Mahalo nui loa for allowing me to share this time with you. Stay safe. Stay strong, stay educated.